On Friday, December the 4th, the year 2015, it's time for Wealth and Wisdom with Fred Belcastro from the John Nevitta Broadcast Center on Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM Norwich and the Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network. And now, here he is, Mr. Fred Belcastro.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you.
Smiles with you.
And when you're laughing,
when you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing,
when the sun comes shining through.
Shining through.
When you're crying,
when you're crying,
you bring on the rain.
Bring on the
stop
rain.
Your sighing,
stop your sighing.
Won't you be happy again?
Happy again.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
keep on smiling,
keep on smiling,
and the world will.
Good morning and welcome once again to the Wealth and Wisdom program. My name is Fred Belcastro, your host, and during the next 30 minutes, we're going to talk about how we can use wisdom, our wisdom, to grow and protect our wealth. We're fortunate to be able to be broadcasting from the John Nevitta Broadcast Center here on the northwest side of Chicago, and you're listening to us on Jack FM 89.7 WRHS out of Norwich. For years I've been talking about using our wisdom to make the money grow, to make and protect our dollars and the advance of our dollars, and I've said that there's more to be gained by eliminating the losses. I said we're throwing away, we're using more of the dollars in various expenses, and we'd be so much better off by eliminating those losses rather than sit here once a week, like you'll hear at every seminar and every radio broadcast and every book, and telling us how to become winners and how to pick the right stock or the right philosophy or the right strategy. I said there's more to be gained by eliminating the losses than by trying to pick winners. You know, we can go through all the point and figure charts and all the analysis of technical and fundamental analysis and get this free software and attend that free seminar in the world and be no better off. If you knew the truth, and the truth was understood at some point in your life to become untrue, when would you want to know about it? If all the things that we thought were absolutely true, absolute facts, but then somewhere down the road they turned out not to be true, when would we want to know? Would we really want to know? Would we really want to face? And so I'm talking about, gee, I think we have a better plan. Maybe instead of how to grow our wealth and protect it, maybe we can talk about how to fail. That's funnier. That's simpler. How to fail. Well, let's see. Some time ago, I started with the 10 erosion factors, and there's about 8 of these factors that are actually parasites. There's taxes. We love to pay taxes, and if we gave all of our money away in the form of taxation, that's it. We'd fail, wouldn't we? We couldn't accumulate any money if we were taxed to death. And how about if the dollars that we brought home were meaningless? They said in Germany, during the height of inflation, if you wanted to sit down and buy a cup of coffee, you'd be better off buying 2 cups at the same time, because by the time you finished 1 cup of coffee, the other price would have increased. That's what inflation does. Inflation brings a $10,000 income from 1960, and we bring it now to 2015. It puts you at a poverty level. How about the lost opportunity? Ah, gee, look at what we could have done with that money if we didn't pay the taxes, maybe if there wasn't inflation. How about interest rates? Ah, look at the money we would have saved if we didn't have to pay all the interest on our home, all the interest in our automobile, all the interest in our credit cards. Oh, we can deduct the interest in our our automobile expense, can't we? We can deduct the interest that we pay on credit cards and revolving charges. Do you remember that? There's where we go right back to taxes and saying, yeah, they used to be deductible, but they eliminated it. They didn't raise the taxes. No, the taxes weren't raised. Still paying a marginal rate of 18%, 19%, 25%, whatever that may be. But they eliminated the deductions. How about the expense that we paid? Pay 18%, 12%, 15%, 27% on credit cards? Ah, that's it. Let's put all of our money in credit cards. Let's borrow our standard of living so we can surely fail. How about the costs that we pay? Some time ago, there was legislation passed because people started to become aware of the amount of dollars that they were paying the brokerage houses and the investment houses for the financial costs. The 401(3)s were in excess of 4%. People caught on. We have to bury those costs a little deeper. That's how to fail. Let's give all of our money away on financial costs, interest expense, inflation and taxes. And then, of course, the old standby market fluctuation. I know that if I want to lose money, put it into risky investments. What's a risky investment? Well, a risky investment to me is anything that could have you lose money. No, you'll say. Sit back, Fred. I don't ever want to lose money. You don't want to lose money. You buy a mutual fund. Does it go up and down? Yeah, but it goes back up again. Did you ever have a broker tell you that you haven't lost money, we've got a gain? And then did you ever have a broker tell you that you're underwater, you've taken a little bit of a loss this year? And when you're taking a little bit of loss, it's always explained this way. It's a paper loss. Not a real loss. It's a paper loss. And then does he tell you that it's a paper gain when you're ahead? We don't do that, do we? But with market fluctuation comes the possibility of loss. And that's how we can fail. Pay our taxes, give up money and lost opportunity, pay all of our expenses on credit cards, pay the interest, and invest our money in products that can go down and be decreased in value. And, of course, put ourselves out there so we're liable for lawsuits by not protecting what we have. All those contribute to the losses. And yet, when we talk about one of the greatest investment advisors in the world today, Warren Buffett. Warren Buffett said the two rules. This is silly. I don't like to use these. Two rules: never lose money. Rule number one. Number two is always pay attention to rule number one. Don't lose money. That's how you do it. Well, at this point, you probably would throw your hands up in the air and say, yeah, there isn't anything we can do about it. We have all of these parasites, as you call them, or these erosion factors taking our dollars. But if I didn't have an answer to these problems, if I didn't have a solution to these problems, I wouldn't be talking to you. I've been on the radio now for a couple of years with my director, John DeVita. And if we didn't have a crystal view of what we don't want, we really don't know what we should be doing, what we really want. Because if we don't want to lose money, and we just constantly throw money into mutual funds that fluctuate and can cost you money, then we really don't want to get ahead. We want to fail. We want to lose money. But if there's a way, we want to eliminate the risks of losses, of taxes, investment fees, and commissions. But and there is, and I'll bring that plan to you. If you're interested in knowing more about how you can eliminate these losses, give me a call. My phone number is area 630-673-4360. I talk about what we don't want, what we don't want, what we don't want, but it's not enough just to know what we don't want. We need to know what we really want. I think the starting point here is what we should call our monetary needs. These are things that we all aspire for our money. If we sit down over a cup of coffee, we'll all talk and say, yeah, this is what I want. This is what I I want to accomplish, and this would be what would guarantee my success at the wealth building game. I think the first thing on everyone's mind, it should be safe. Safety is a primary function. The others would be growth. We'd want our money to grow. We would, of course, want to be able to have an income, so someday when we're unable to work or we choose not to work, we have a sufficient amount of income coming in. Remember I told you that as a young man from a very wealthy businessman in Chicago, I learned the importance of liquidity. So we have to be able to get at our money, and, of course, we have to get at our money without the taxes. So if we were to look at safe, we want our money to be safe. Nobody wants to lose the risk of principal. We don't ever want to do that. But yet we invest in things that go up and down. A couple of things that that we have as far as risk is concerned. One is the things that we put our money into. If we put it into a fluctuating market, we could expect to have some down years. We could expect to have our principal decrease. If we don't want that, then don't put your money in securities. Don't purchase investments, instruments, or markets that can go down in value. We work hard for our principal. Why do you put it at risk, or why do you put it into something that could decrease in value? And of course, we don't want to hand our money over to Bernie Madoff either. We want some guarantees that in addition to a proven track record, that the individuals that we have monitoring our accounts are trustworthy and exercise a degree in fidelity. Not just talk about having a fiduciary arrangement. I've heard that so often on the radio. We have a fiduciary arrangement. Everybody that takes that Series 7 passes it has a fiduciary arrangement. So these words are meaningless. They're falling on your ears, and if you just swallow them hook, line, and sinker, you're looking for another Bernie Madoff, I guess. When it comes to growth, don't we want to have more money tomorrow than we do today? Isn't that what growth is about? Don't we want that to happen always? You know, if we want that to happen, we truly want it to happen, that would eliminate most of the investments. Eliminate stocks, doesn't it? Stocks go down. Bonds go down. Mutual funds go down. How about real estate, commodities? How about the precious metals and things that we collect and options and other investments? In fact, it eliminates mostly everything that gives us a decent chance at a reasonable retirement. It does not, but we're not there yet. The point is that uninterrupted growth means compounding. Remember Einstein, we talked about compounding, and it's uninterrupted growth. You need approximately 20 years for compounding to really have an effect. And yet, who of us has our money compounding at 20 years without exercising any degree of loss whatsoever? Why don't we take a break and give me a chance to have a sip of coffee, and we'll get back to you in a couple of minutes.
Sin to tell a lie. Billions of hearts have been broken because these words have been spoken. I love you, yes I do, I love you. If you break my heart, I'll die. So be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Sin to not reply. phone starts vibrating. I heart you, yes I do, I heart you. When you ping me back, I'll sigh. So be sure you do when you say I'll text you. It's a sin to not read. You better text me back, boy. It's a sin to not reply.
It's a sin to tell a lie. And if you haven't guessed who presented that for us this morning, it was Mrs. Rachel Menke. Who's Rachel Menke? Well, she's a lady that dropped out of college and bought a ukulele for $25 and started learning how to play and created an album, a musical album, went back to school. Today she's a Lutheran minister in the Boston area, playing a song that was written in 1936. She recorded that in just June of this year, 2015. I thought it would be an interesting song and an interesting representation. But getting back to the safety, growth, income, liquidity, there'll come a time in all of our lives, I think, when we want to stop working, and whether or not we have to because of health or employment situations. But we'd like our dollars then to carry on and do the things that we've been working for during the last 30 or 40 years. And we'd like to be able to retire or stop working or have an income without the sacrifices of not having a sufficient amount of dollars coming in. And I like to talk about liquidity because I said, well, if we have safety and growth and we have a sufficient income and we can't get out our money, particularly in the event of an emergency or an opportunity, what good is it? If all of our money is locked up somewhere and we can't get at it, like a Fort Knox, there's going to be a question whether or not there is a sufficient amount of gold there. We're going to be questioning Bernie whether or not we really do have all this money invested with him. So anything that's highly illiquid or that doesn't give us a return on our investment, what real good is it? The question that was asked to me by a mentor of mine some years ago, Fred, is it liquid? Keep my money liquid. And that's how he became a multimillionaire. And, of course, the first thing I mentioned, of course, is tax and the erosion factors. You have something that's taxed to death. If every time we have 10% of growth, we have to give away 30 or 50% of that, what good is it? Whether we've chosen to accumulate a qualified plan like an IRA, 401, or the others, we face a huge tax liability at the end of the line, a liability that's greater than all the deductions that we've been given during the accumulation. So a lot of us don't pay much mind to the silent partner that we have, but Uncle Sam's a silent partner, and at some point in time when we withdraw the money, or you can't bury it at 70 and a half, you're going to have to start withdrawing it, and he wants his money, he wants his cut of the pie. So other than that, we want to build our money, we want it tax efficient. And the most tax efficient is something tax-free. You'd like something tax-free? Give me a call, 630-673-4360. Now, we look back on this list. I've talked safety, growth, income, liquidity, and tax efficiency. Which of those are defensive? We could look at the three of them that are defensive in nature: to safety, liquidity, tax efficiency. That's consistent with what I've said in the past over the last couple of years on the radio. Save your money. Don't throw away the money on opportunity costs that never come to roost. The two money, the other ones are offensive would be the growth in income. And I think income is mostly a function on how we do growing our money by the time we need it. But I always talk to my audience about a series of questions or thoughts that we should give to these programs. I've talked now about the liquidity, tax efficiency, income growth. Okay, from that list of five, what's missing? Is there anything missing? Is there something more that we need in order for us not to fail? Is there something more that we need to make our lives successful, our financial lives? Can you think of anything? And we have safety, growth, income, liquidity, efficiency as far as taxes are concerned. What's not important? Is there something we could take off that list? Are there any other things that have to be considered other than those five? And if we could achieve all five of those needs, what do you think our chance of financial success would be? You think it would be pretty good? If our money was guaranteed safe, if always the day after we had more money than we did the day before, if we had the rights to take an income from that money sufficient for us to live on, if our money was liquid, we could get at it in the event of an emergency without paying fees and interest expense, if our money was tax-free or tax-efficient, you see? This is a point of consideration. Is your portfolio right now invested in the things that meet all these five needs? And the five needs, listen, the five needs, this is important. These things have to be done at the same time. You see, you have to have growth and safety at the same time. You have to be able to get your money and have it tax efficient at the same time. See, okay, if you took this list, just five little requirements, and brought them to your investment advisor right now, and insisted that your investments or your portfolio is filled with things that meet these qualifications, would he say that you have all those? See, the list is complete. This is what you need. There's nothing missing from it. You need the safety. You need the growth. You need income. You need the liquidity. And it has to be tax efficient. If you don't have these things in your portfolio, if you're not accumulating money in this method, your chances of winning this game with investments and 401ks is less than 100%. If you do have these requirements in your portfolio, chances are very great that you will meet your financial needs. These things are what you really want. You want money. You want it safe. You know, you want to be able to take an income from it. You want to be able to get your money at any time that it's needed. You know. I hope that the answer now is starting to become a little more clear to you, and what I'm getting to. The Wall Street. And listen, I've worked for Wall Street for 50 years. Wall Street may not be the solution, may not be all that you're looking for. But Wall Street and the advisors and the strategies, listen, they're designed first for whose benefit? They're designed for the benefit of Wall Street. And who has all the money in the world? Is it the financial institutions? Who do you think comes up with these plans and these strategies that you'll sit down in seminars? Is it Wall Street? Who do you think they're geared to benefit? It's Wall Street. And if you can keep us happy with a few crumbs, most of us, we don't object. We're like sheep being led to a slaughter. And we keep depositing month after month and year after year more of our money with them, rationalizing them as they're the experts, and they're operating, of course, in our best interests. Why don't we take a few more minutes off and let me calm down a little bit and get away from some of these lies that we're hearing about all the time.
The moon was all aglow, and heaven was in your eyes. The night that you told me those little white lies. The stars all seem to know that you didn't mean all those sighs. The night that you told me those little white lies, I try, but there's no forgetting when evening appears. I but there is no regretting in spite of my tears. Who wouldn't believe those lips? Whoever could doubt those eyes? The night that you told me those little white lies.
Those Little White Lies from 1947 with Dick Ames. Boy, that'll calm me down, wouldn't it? Look, I don't mean to harp on Wall Street, but they're well orchestrated, they're coordinated. They've planned this out, my friends. We got magazines, ads, newspapers, personalities on radio and television and in person, reinforcing the idea that the herd mentality, it creates a sense of security because everybody's doing it. This is what you're supposed to do. There is an answer, my friends. There's a different way. I have the answer. 630 area, 673-4360. I'm not talking for nothing. The fact is that Wall Street doesn't have anything. There's nothing in the Wall Street world that meets all these five money needs at the same time. And what's worse, that we're taught that the more we demand of our money, the less we get from the others. Do you want more safety? Well, you've got to give up maybe some security with that. Do you want growth? Well, you have to give up that safety, the risk-reward equation, right? Nothing ventured, nothing gained. Do you want income? Well, then you have to give up growth. You can't have both. That's what we're led to believe. Do you want more liquidity? Then don't tie your money up in a CD or bonds or real estate. Do you want something tax efficient? Hey, good luck, pal. There's nothing on the drawing board, nothing that'll give you that. So trading our money need for one or the other is really no good. We're not getting ahead by having safety and yet no yield or no income or liquidity. We're just diminishing our chances of success as far as our money is concerned. Look, let me take a break. Let me take a breath. Do one thing. Do it for me, please. Just evaluate. Take a look at what you have. Take a look at what you're investing in your strategies. And compare them against these five money needs or requirements. Safety, growth, income, liquidity, tax efficiency. Take that list. Take that list to your advisor. Demand that you fill your portfolio with things that meet these requirements. There isn't anything here that's missing. We all agree that these are the things that are needed. They won't be able to do it because they don't have the answer. Wall Street doesn't have the answer. There is a way you can. I could show you that way. Fred Belcastro, give me a call. Area 630-673-4360. And let's not keep following the herd and failing. So, all right, we've got a nice day, a nice weekend planned. Our time is just about over. Want to thank you all. Thank John DeVita, our director, this morning. Thank you for listening. And as we go about our way in the days to come, be kind to one another and make somebody smile. Talk to you again next week. Thanks for listening.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you.
Smiles with you.
And when you're laughing,
when you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing.
When the sun comes shining through,
shining through.
When you're crying,
when you're crying,
you bring on the rain. Stop your sighing,
stop your
sighing. Won't you be happy again?
Happy again.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling.
Keep on smiling,
keep on smiling,
and the world will smile.
You have been listening to Wealth and Wisdom with Fred Belcastro from the John DeVita Broadcast Center on Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM Norwich and the Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network on Friday, December the 4th, the year of our Lord, 2015. This broadcast was directed by John DeVita. Our special thanks to radio station manager Kevin Zeflik of WRHS-FM Norwich and the executive producer of Windy City Hometown Entertainment, Mr. John Secondo. Until next time, please be safe and thanks for listening. Today's broadcast was pre-recorded on Wednesday, December the 2nd, the year of our Lord, 2015. Have a great day, everyone. And this is Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM, Norwich, Illinois. Have a great weekend, friends, and we'll see you next week.